Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Thursday, SpaceX launched another Falcon 9 rocket for the Starlink 421 mission. The booster which launched this mission, B1058, then landed successfully for the 13th time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage 1 has ignited one engine.
Landing leg deploy.
There are some more launches that we can hopefully expect this coming week. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the Starlink 3-1 launch is scheduled to lift off tomorrow, Monday 11th at 1:39 a.m. UTC or today at 9:39 p.m. EDT. In addition, there is the launch of CRS-25 scheduled to lift off on Friday 15th at 12:30 a.m. UTC or Thursday 14th at 8:30 p.m. EDT. SpaceX posted a couple of pictures of Starlinks on a boat. They said Starlink Maritime allows you to connect from some of the most remote waters in the world. SpaceX also posted another Starlink-related tweet. It says, in addition to withstanding extreme cold heat, hail, sleet, heavy rain and gale force winds, Starlink is rugged enough to withstand rocket landings. Here's live video captured on a SpaceX drone ship at sea with and without Starlink. Sawyer Merritt posted an interesting tweet in light of the Starlink for Boats news. He said, Starlink increases SpaceX recovery fleet throughput by 5,900%, reduces costs by 70%. At over 165k per month for 25 megabit download and 25 megabit upload of prepaid bandwidth, satellite internet was one of the top operating costs for SpaceX's recovery fleet. Heading over to Boca Chica, work continues on the orbital launch mount. Work is also continuing on the chopstick catching arms. The chopsticks were also seen being tested recently. This new orbital launch mount work platform was delivered to the launch site. The work up at the top of the mega bay continues. Of course, work also continues on the Star Factory production building. There was an article posted related to a lawsuit against Cameron County regarding SpaceX Roden Beach closures. The article says a lawsuit filed against Cameron County for closing Boca Chica Beach for SpaceX tests has been denied. John Winkert posted some cool pictures of the progress on structures being built at the Cape. On the right is the base of the launch tower and on the left is a mystery structure they are building. This booster thrust assembly was seen being flipped in the yard. Here's a view of the new ship noses inside the fabrication tent. Michael Baylor posted some tweets about filings by SpaceX for launching Starship and Super Heavy to orbit for the first time. The first tweet says SpaceX has submitted new FCC filings for Starlink communications during the Starship orbital test flight. Multiple terminals will be mounted on the ship and the booster to ensure clear views with the constellation through all phases of flight. Next, he posted flight profile details. Booster will either do a partial return and land in the Gulf of Mexico or do a full return with a catch attempt. Ship will reach about 250 kilometers in altitude, then powered landing in the Pacific. After that, he posted Starlink will allow high data rate communications and remove telemetry blackouts during re-entry. Finally, he posted a picture saying Super Heavy catch attempt profile. I want to share a couple of tweets from Eric Berger. The first says, it is now more than theoretical that SpaceX's Starship and NASA's Space Launch System rocket could make their orbital launch attempts during the same month, August 2022. Then, he also posted the off-the-record for planning purposes only dates for the two launches are now within 21 days of one another. The Starship launch date is much more slippery, but if they get through the static fire test in the next week or two, oh my. SpaceX posted some absolutely amazing pictures on Twitter of the Starship 24 prototype rolling out and sitting at the launch site. After being moved to the suborbital launch site, Ship 24 was lifted onto the Pad B mount. Work continues on Ship 24 prototype to prepare it for a static fire. Work has continued on the Super Heavy Booster 7 prototype as it sits atop the orbital launch mount. Booster 7 was also seen performing some more testing recently. There were also some tests of the grid fin seen being performed. Taking a look at the Roden Beach closures on the Cameron County website, there are still a bunch of dates for this coming week. There are possible closures currently scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 11th, Tuesday 12th, Wednesday 13th and Thursday 14th. On top of that, there is another possible closure for next week with Monday 18th. At some point, the Booster 8 forward section was moved over and into the Mega Bay. RGV Aerial Photography posted this picture of Super Heavy Booster 8 now fully stacked in the Mega Bay. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, known as Boca Chica Gala, Nick Antsuini for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.